How often do you use your phone? What do you use your phone for? Do you use your phone for school, leisure, or simply for business? Or do you use it for something else which I did not mention? What value does it give you after using your phone? Will you regret the time you spent on using your phone later on? Nevertheless, this video will help you understand if your phone is taking advantage of you or if it's you taking advantage of your phone. So stay tuned until the end. In this video, I'll talk about how excessive use of your phone will affect your physical and mental health. And I'll also add some tips on how you can minimize the damage that can be done from excessively using your phone if by any chance you cannot reduce the amount of time you need to use your phone in a day or in a week or something of that sort. Everybody has this something which is called getting used to something, or in other words, getting comfortable with doing something or with something being at a specific time or something of a sort. Imagine if the gate of your house changed direction and was put on a different direction rather than it usually is. You are more likely to find yourself at the old gate point because you are used to it being there instead of the new destination where the gate is now located. Okay, so you are probably wondering, where am I getting with this? Basically saying, doesn't mean if something is considered to be a norm is always right. Different things become irrelevant with time. And this is the reason you might want to cut your phone usage right now after watching this video. Studies have shown that a person spends 4 or more hours daily on their phone, not to mention the whole 6 hours spent online at night. Are you one of them? The reality is that this might be good or bad depending on what you use your phone for. The more you use your phone, the higher the chances of you wanting to use your phone more. This is caused by dopamine. A whole new video on dopamine coming very soon on the channel. What dopamine does is that it makes you get addicted to your phone or social media or to anything that you can think of. It can be alcohol, it can be anything. As long as you are getting addicted to it, it can be caused by dopamine. Phone addiction can negatively affect your life, health, school, job, or business. Before we go deep into how your phone can negatively affect your life, health, school, job, or business, here are 4 signs that you need to cut back on your screen time. Sign number 1, sleep deprivation. You will know this when you always sleep at a.m. instead of sleeping at p.m., which means if you always sleep after midnight, then you probably might need to cut back on your screen time. Sign number 2 is if you are hooked to your phone very much. If you are unable to unengage from your phone without physically being distracted, you really need to cut back on the usage of your phone. Sign number 3 is lack of interest. What do I mean by this? If your interest in other aspects of life that is not regarding your phone has been gradually decreasing, this is a sign that you might need to follow some precautions. Sign number 4, app usage. If you spend more than 3 hours or more between only 3 social media apps or games, or simply between 3 programs or softwares, as to say, then you might really need to cut back on your phone usage time. How does phone addiction affect your life? It increases loneliness and depression. It is now more than ever that people are more likely to base their self-worth on social media likes. Now people are more focused on social media traction, and if they did not get enough traction, they really devalue themselves. Phone addiction also encourages FOMO, fear of missing out. Phone addiction on health affects both physical and mental health. Phone addiction can cause pain and discomforts, eyes burn and become itchy, and eye fatigue. But even if you are aware of all these things, you are still more likely to continue and ignore the fact that it is your phone which is causing all these negative things to your health. Mental health is mostly caused by sleep deprivation, which in return causes depression. Now I'll tell you how phone addiction affects your school or job or business. This should be obvious. It leads to lower productivity and high risks of losing probability potentials. We've all been there. We've all once wanted to do something, and instead we find ourselves scrolling through Instagrams for more than 30 minutes or even an hour, and it might cause procrastination time and again, and sometimes it is the reason why we've never started some big projects or never started studying for that test assignment or pretty much getting a task done. And this might cause very huge negative impacts in somebody's life or in your own life as well. Phone addiction probably comes without you really knowing how it happens. If somebody comes to you and tell you are addicted to your phone, you are more likely to say you are not. If you are somebody who uses your phone for a job or simply for business, you might want to use your phone more frequently than somebody who is just at home sitting on the couch and watching videos on internet or probably scrolling through social media for the whole day without doing anything else apart from eating and going to the toilet. So, my name is Will Tries, business and internet nerd. That is it for this video, guys. I hope you really enjoyed it, even though I made this video in a rush and I didn't really get enough time to explain these things really deep, but I'll be making more videos about such related things. On this channel, I make videos about business, life, and finances. More videos will be coming very soon on the channel, so stay tuned for that. And I'll be trying myself to push out a new video every single week. See you on the next video. See you next week.